Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and today is the second anniversary of my YouTube channel, so I thought I would make a little special. And as a subject for my special, I choose something that does not have necessarily much to do with redstone itself, but more with how to deal with those annoying little cave systems you run randomly into while building your contraptions, or just running along the way. And that is the so-called Trémaux algorithm, also called the bidirectional double tracing algorithm, which is a technique that was discovered or invented to find out of a labyrinth, but can also be applied to caving in Minecraft. I will divide this little special in four parts. The first part is the Trémaux algorithm itself, how it's in its sense made or done. Then I will show you it applied to a little two-dimensional labyrinth you can see here. Third part is showing you how I apply it to cave diving, and the fourth part is what I usually have with me when I start caving, simply to give you a little heads up what you might want to take with you when you are going exploring. But anyway, that's enough of the prologue, so let's start with showing you how this algorithm actually works. Okay, so let's start with how this Trémaux algorithm or bidirectional double tracing algorithm actually works. Basically, you have two phases, you switch back and forth depending on certain conditions. The first phase I will use normal torches, the second phase I will use redstone torches to mark the difference in between. So now what are those phases? Basically you have an exploration phase, which means that you just walk forward, explore new paths, and when you come to a cross-section or a split in the path, you just choose more or less randomly where to go from there on. And the second phase is a backtracing phase, where you walk backwards and until certain conditions are met again and you go back to the exploration phase. So now let's show you how this works with a rather simple example here. So for the beginning you start with the exploration phase, and while doing this you mark the path you walk once, like this. Now, when you come to a cross-section, you choose randomly where to go from here on. I am going straight forward in this case, and you just mark the path along when you walk. Now I have another split in the path, I just choose once more to go forward. Here the same thing, and so on and so on. You can also mark the path along while you walk. Now I have reached a dead end, which means I can't go any further exploring, which means I have to go to the second phase, which is the backtracing phase. And now I start marking the path a second time. And that's the basic idea behind this. So a path that has been marked twice is dead to me. It does not contain anything that's interesting to me anymore, and it's pretty much the same as it weren't even there. So paths that have been marked twice, you just ignore from there on. So now I have come back to this split in the path. One pathway I have explored, and the second path here has not been explored yet. Which means that now it's time to explore this path here. And now I've reached a point where I already have been, as you can see with those markers here, which means that it's time to go back to the backtracing phase and mark this path as closed or dead. Now in this case I have two paths that are dead, one path I have come through, come from, and nothing else, so I must backtrace more until I come to this split in the path here, where I can go back to the exploration phase again, until I reach this point here where I have already been. So it's time to backtrace again. Now I have dead ends here, and the path I came from, and here the same thing, and I'm back at the very beginning. And as you can see here, all paths have been explored, and due to the way this algorithm works, I have explored every path in both directions, which is a rather good idea, for example, in Minecraft caves, since if you have overlooked a vein of ore from one direction, it's highly probable that you will at least see it from the other direction. But anyway, that's the basic idea behind this. Now I will show you how this looks, or how this can be applied if you find yourself in a little labyrinth here. Okay, so now I am in the middle of a little labyrinth, which I built some time ago, so I don't really know where the exit is, which means that basically we just use our Trémaux algorithm and choose randomly a pathway, for example this one, and start marking our pathway. And this is a dead end, so back to the backtracing. And basically this path is not what we are looking for, so let's go for the next path. So let's choose this way here. And this is a dead end, so let's go to the backtracing. Now it's the Trémaux algorithm all over again. Okay, this we can just mark off. And a dead end again. Now it's back to the backtracing, and we found our exit of the whole thing here. And that's the whole thing applied to a two-dimensional labyrinth here. Another nice thing here about this is if you follow the path that's only marked once, you have a direct link from your starting position to the exit and vice versa, which means that you can, if you have lost something along the way or left something back here, you can always find your way back to this point there. The only thing this algorithm needs to work is the ability to mark pathways twice, and the ability to go back the pathway you went through. So this algorithm does not work if you have something like one-way streets in here, where you can only go in one direction. But other than that, it doesn't matter if it's a two-dimensional labyrinth like this here, or even a three-dimensional labyrinth with loops and even canyons like cave systems sometimes have in Minecraft. It can always be applied and be used to find your way out of a cave system or of a labyrinth, or in case of the way I use it, you can use it to find a way or to go to every little dead end and passageway of the whole labyrinth or cave system to find all the ore that's visible. And that's basically what I will show you as an example in a few moments. Okay, so I just found a little cave I can show you the Trémaux algorithm with in application, as I use it when I'm doing some caving experience. And all I need usually are some torches and some dirt blocks to mark the passageways, and that's basically all of the required resources. I will show you later what I usually run along with in my inventory when I'm going caving. But anyway, let's start with the whole experience. So all I'm doing is basically just running through here. And you might notice that when I'm going down, I put the torches directly on top of the edges, which also gives me a direction, which comes into play later on. But anyway, that's I'll just ignore those ores for the moment. But anyway, that's just how I'm doing this. So as you can see, when I'm going upwards, I put the torches on the side of the edge, which again gives me a direction. So I can always backtrace, even if I fall in through a hole or while I'm digging for some redstone contraptions, I can always follow the direction those torches give me and will find out of the whole cave system. But anyway, now I have reached another exit of the whole system, so this is not interesting for me at the moment, and it's time to backtrace basically. And for this I start marking off this passageway as dead. So all I'm doing is basically putting a dirt block down. I'm using dirt since it's rather rare down in the caves, but it's not that rare that I won't find anything if I'm running low of dirt blocks. So I'm using a dirt block, and then I'm putting a torch on it, so I also have a direction, which means that basically this basically means that I have to go this direction to backtrace. And that's basically all I'm doing. So now I'm back at this cross section here, where I also put down a dirt block, since it's enough to mark the explored paths whenever there is a cross section. Dirt blocks also have the advantage that they are highly visible from even greater distances due to the fact that they have a completely different color and texture from the normal stone around. And well, that's basically the whole thing in a nutshell. So I have yet again another cross section that I just choose randomly. And as you can see, it's a rather simple and fast way to explore. And now we have another dead end. So I can just go back. Mark this off as explored and start going down. And usually when I'm running into water or such things, I just cut it off, since it's otherwise a bit annoying to go swimming all the time. But anyway, that's basically how I go exploring. And depending on the size of the whole cave system, it can be quite lengthy time-wise. And you might want to backtrace to your base or to the exit of the whole thing at some point to put down a chest with the ores and other valuables you have found along the way. And that's basically also really simple. All you have to do is just walk along the one marked path. And as you can see, here is a point where I actually overlooked this cross-section. I was going in this direction simply due to the fact that I had to lighten up the whole place. And now that I'm going in the opposite direction, I can actually see it and later on explore it. Maybe you want to put down some kind of mark, for example. Something. And that's basically the whole thing in a nutshell. So anyway, if you want to go back, you just follow your once marked path. This path is not what we want. And then you're back at the very beginning. You can plunk down your chest and put your valuables in there and can go straight back, just following the once marked path, and you're back where you started with your inventory run. Another great advantage of this is if you were killed while exploring, you spawn somewhere up there, and you can again follow your once marked path until you reach the point where you were killed. And if it's not too far and the items despawn after 5 minutes, you will have found the place where you died. You will be able to actually just get your stuff back, which is also a rather nice advantage of the whole thing here. But anyway, I believe that's enough of an example of how to use this while caving. So the last part of this little special here is showing you what I usually have in my inventory when I start exploring. Okay, so what do I have in my inventory when I start caving? Let's start with a good set of armor. Doesn't hurt if it's also enchanted. The reason for this is rather self-explanatory, unless you're playing in peaceful mode. You will encounter quite a few hostile mobs, and without armor this is a suicidal mission. In combination with that, you should also have a good sword. Doesn't hurt if it's enchanted too. And optional a bow and some arrows, since in most cases you can get into melee range. A bow is optional, but it's not a bad idea to have one anyway. Then, further necessities are torches. A full stack at the beginning should be enough. And combined with this, you should have a full stack of wood. Doesn't matter which kind, but you should have a full stack of wood. So you can make new torches along the way, since you will find a lot of coal. And combined this with the wood, you can make torches anytime. Then, furthermore, you should have two diamond pickaxes. Both should have an unbreaking, and at least one should have a Fortune 3 enchantment. The reason I'm usually running along with two is basically I'm using the normal pickaxe to just get to the places I want to. For example, if I am in a canyon, I usually have to dig up a bit, make me a few stairs in the walls to get to the valuables. And then when I'm running along coal, diamonds, or redstone or such things, I'm using my fortune pickaxe to get a bit more out of them. So now, why am I not using a thick touch pickaxe, as some guides say would be recommended? It's rather simple. If you combine this with a crafting table I usually have with me, and that is rather simple. With a crafting table you are able to put 9 coal, diamond or redstone, for example, into one block, which is much more compact as compared with the ore, even if you mine it with a Fortune 3 diamond axe later on. The only exception to this would be Lapis Lazuli, which drops a bit more than 9 items per ore, but for one exception this is not necessary to have a third diamond axe with a few, and that would be just a waste of resources. Then, furthermore, you should have some roast chicken or otherwise foodstuff with you, due to self-explanatory reasons, of course. Then another thing I usually have with me is at least half a stack of dirt, due to the way I'm using my backtracing algorithm I showed you a few moments ago. And then, which is rather optional again, is a bucket of water and some ladders. Water to get away from dangerous points with lava, dangerous situations with lava, and ladders to get up or down without having to pillar with some blocks. Okay, so that was how the Trémaux algorithm actually works and how I apply it to my cave diving experience in Minecraft. I hope you got something out of this tutorial and actually enjoyed it. And, well, if you didn't enjoy it or have other ideas for tutorials or specials that don't have to necessarily have to do anything with redstone contraptions themselves, just put down a comment or send me a message and I will see what I can do for you. But anyway, that is the end of this little special. I hope you enjoyed it, and, well, see ya!